Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Portal 2. Me, Bogoblin Gamer. A potato. There's the elevator. Dude. 37 kilometers. Oh no, wait, it's like 3,000, isn't it? 4,000 meters. Meters. And that's it. That's a long fall. And now the depths. Depth of aperture. The depths. Deadly depths. Deadly, dastardly depths. There's a flood up, it's been falling. It's underneath the table. You wake up and this is Apocalypse Land. Apocalypse Land will be the title of this segment because I have no better title yet. Boom. Nope, wrong way. In the dirt. For some reason I'm doing this. Let me win. Oh, crap. Cram it. Yeah. Now, nah, we can get up there. If I can shoot it, cool. Do not enter. Keep out. Out, keep. Upstairs and down the corridor. Because down and up. Cool words meaning they've got. This is kind of neat. Neat is also cool. There's one. See this one first today. Now, and yeah, it's the gate people. The gate people with the Notre Dame housing estate. Stuff in the sky. There's tiny door behind the massive vault door. I think that's funny. I think that is funny, so I will comment on it. However, there are no walls. There are no walls. What? Yeah, we win. Oh no, burning. Burning. Ah. Considering this is the third chapter I'm recording in this session, then that's where we go. Get in. Right, now, there are some insane speed running tricks. Alright. I'm trying to iron that out still. Oh god. Overlap.
So these pre-recorded messages will cover any questions you might have and respond to any incidents that may occur in the course of your science adventure.
Messages all. I purposely died there. Because purposely dying is my favourite pastime. Not future time. Future time is silly.
And respond to any incidents that may occur in the course of your science adventure. Your test assignment will vary depending on the manner in which you have bent the world to your will. Those of you helping us test the repulsion gel today, just follow the blue line on the floor. Those of you who volunteered to be injected with freeing mantis DNA, I've got some good news and some bad news. Bad news is we're postponing those tests indefinitely. Good news is, we've got a much better test
much
for you.
Better test.
Fighting an army of mantis men. Pick up a rifle and follow the yellow line.
No, I would say. That noise thing. That people call baby laughter. Soul. Do not fall down elevator shaft. Ever later. And enemies. Don't touch anything unfamiliar. Don't inhale fumes. No matter how good they smell. Oh wow. Gel flow line.
They say great science is built on the shoulders of giants.
Not here.
At Aperture, we do all our science from scratch. No hand holding.
They do all their science in scratch, you know, that program that you get on the internet. Scratch is weird. Weird and odd and odd and weird. My favorite saying ever. And the lights go on. See if we can get the rest of this recorded today. That would be nice.
First test involves something the lab boys call repulsion gel.
Repulsion gel.
You're not part of the control group, by the way. You get the gel. Last poor son of a gun got blue paint. All joking aside, that did happen. Broke every bone in his legs.
That's right. Well, informative. Peace pictures. Yeah, I'm epic at this chapter. It's my favorite chapter.
I should not have mentioned the control room. They're telling me I ought to stop making these pre-recorded messages. That gave me an idea to make more pre-recorded messages. I pay the bills here.
Better still can't aim properly. But I know where to go. You go left here. In my favorite.
For this next test, we put nanoparticles in the gel. In layman's terms, that's a billion little gizmos that are going to travel into your bloodstream and pump experimental genes and RNA molecules and so forth into your tumors. Now, maybe you don't have any tumors. Well, don't worry. If you sat on a folding chair in the lobby and weren't wearing lead underpants, we took care of that too.
I always wear lead underpants. Those skills there. Das Hagen Das. Look down. And walk back quicker. Assume the position and charge. Yes.
Oh, in case you got covered in that repulsion gel, here's some advice the lab boy gave me. Do not get covered in the repulsion gel.
Okay.
We haven't entirely nailed down what element it is yet, but I'll tell you this, it's a lively one, and it does not like the human skeleton.
What was it? So it's nice when your skeleton's eaten by disgusting blue diabetic pudding. Yeah, people don't know what I'm talking about there. There was actually some. It's never mentioned in the game, but there was some trailer footage that said it was like a pudding for diabetics that bounced all the other food out. Asbestos is my favorite.
To a median latency of 44.6 years. So if you're 30 or older, you're laughing. I like your style. You make up your own rules, just like me. Bean Counter said I couldn't fire a man just for being in a wheelchair.
So he's supposed to go. And here's a little cool trick you can do here, so you don't have to get it to work. What? Oh god, I'm being cold again. Oh, why have such a nice ringtone thing? I made it in Audacity in about 10.5 seconds. Oh god, I gotta go and say decline to that. Sauron. He will find out that it was a good reason later on. I hope. Just lodge. Good shape, good luck. Yes.
Just a heads up, that coffee we gave you earlier had fluorescent calcium in it, so we can track the neuronal
activity
in your brain. There's a slight chance the calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction.
That's funny. Look at this. Ben Shaw's Cloudy Lemonade Classic. Enough looking at cans.
Now, if you're part of control group Kepler 7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard into your skull. Likely you forgot it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next test, let us know. Because that means it's about to hit 500 degrees, so we're going to need to go ahead and get that out of you pretty fast.
That one's not a challenge, really.
I'm telling it.
I'm done.
Keep your pants on. All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel as a self-word of advice. If you meet yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact. Lab boys tell me they will wipe out time. Entirely. Forward and backward. So do both of yourselves a favor and just let that handsome devil go about his business.
Yeah. And let's get this. It's kind of clever how you do that. I wonder if it's possible to, like, escape a bit early. But I won't try that this Let's Play, or probably. I won't try that. I'm only going to make one Let's Play. Oh, really?
Well, that boy say that might be a fear reaction. I'm no psychiatrist, but coming from a bunch of eggheads who look like a little danger and walked up and snapped their little pink bras, that sounds like protection. They didn't fly into space, storm a beach, or bring back the gold. No, sir, we did. It's you and me against the world, son. I like your grip. Possibly it's a workout. Now let's solve this thing.
I'll wash this cube first. Washing is the key to all. Yeah. I don't even want to finish the sentence. Because washing is the key to nothing. Washing never did anything for anyone.
Yeah.
Why not?
Why is someone in our science dangerous? Why not merely save science and not so much? In fact, why not invent a special safety door that will keep you on the bottom of the way out because you are fired?
Now you're just tired because the subject is a low
end. Stop. Out the front door. Parking lot. Car. Goodbye.
Parking lot. Car. Imagine if you had a car that had a parking lot on top of it and then you drove it around. And then everybody pointed at you and laughed. And then you were inexplicably dead. But it was okay, because everyone saved me. Oh yeah, that's the end of that. That's the end of that chapter!
You're standing here listening to me means you've made a glorious contribution to science. As
right.
Founder and CEO of Amateur Science, I thank you for your participation, and hope we can count on you for another round of tests.
Goodbye, Carolyn. Pump station beta. Orange room is orange. Now, I have a bit of a dilemma here. So I'm gonna take the really stupid way of doing it.
Greetings, friend. I'm Cave Johnson, CEO of Aperture Science. You might know us as a vital participant in the 1968 Senate hearings on missing astronauts. And you most likely used one of the many products we invented, but that other people have somehow managed to steal from us. Black Mesa can eat my bankrupt.
Sir,
right. Now you might be asking yourself, Cave, just how difficult are these tests? What was in that phone book of a contract I signed? Am I in danger? Let me answer those questions with a question. Who wants to make $60? Cash. You can also feel free to relax for up to 20 minutes in the waiting room, which is a damn sight more comfortable than the park bench
you
were sleeping on when we found you. So, welcome to Aperture. You're here because we want the best, and you're it. Nope. Couldn't keep a straight face. Anyway, don't smudge up the glass down there. In fact, why don't you just go ahead and not touch anything unless it's test-related?
Oh, yeah. Any fans of Half-Life 2 Episode 2 there? And Episode 3, I guess. The Borealis! Yeah, well, there's no Borealis, but... you know, whatever. Nobody knows what the Borealis is it really yet, but... yeah. Whatever, exposition's fun. Yeah, that's kind of a neat little thing they decided to do. And now for Easter egg here, number 2. So we want to shoot portal like right up there. Now we don't want to fall in there. It's not what I wanted to do at all. The hell. Oh, this is weird. Ugh, let's go back up. No. There we go. And so we just chill out down here. Okay, yeah. Little cool little trick you can do here to skip a vital part of the story. Very badly, of course, but no. You a forward jump, well, that's what I call it anyway. Yeah, and then you can actually well, I was gonna say you can actually skip something cool. It seems to be working today. Isn't that odd? It seemed to work fine last time. This works on console and PC, by the way. Maybe you should do it from the stairs. Well, that's not going to work. Yeah, you need to do a forward jump. Which is where you actually... Yay. Oh, I wish I could get this right, it would be nice. This usually works fine. Maybe it's a bit lower. Let's try that.
No! Oh! Oh! So annoying! So annoying! It's so annoying!
Oop. That's not good. Yeah, anyway. I should have been done proving my point like 8.5 minutes ago. Whoop. That didn't work. Today's a good place to face it. So.
Why are you not working? Oh. Oh.
Yeah, let's try this. It doesn't work, then I will keep trying because that's me all over, isn't it, dude? I know you're watching, dude. Why are you so annoying? Crap, screw myself. Yes! There you go. You can skip an important part of the story, and if you haven't played this before, then in the next segment, you'll have no idea what the hell's going on. For now, we're gonna end. Goodbye.